morning. This is Maze of Mustang News at hopefully 7:15, and I'm Tiffany Woodland.
And I'm Ryan Gleason. Today we have a wide variety of news subjects to cover, so let's get it started right away and send it over to Tiffany for the news on a new amendment to the Constitution.
July 1st, 1971, the 26th Amendment was ratified. This new amendment was given 18-year-olds or older the right to vote. And the right to vote shall not be denied or abridged by the United States or by any state on account of age. The Congress shall have power to enforce this article by appropriate legislation. There were endless protests over the draft being called up for military service. All males over the age of 18 were eligible for the draft, but the minimum voting age was 21. It was widely considered unfair that these 18-year-olds were eligible for military service and therefore old enough to fight and die for their country, but didn't have the right to vote. The 14th Amendment had guaranteed the right to vote in non-direct language to 21-year-old men. This was the basis of the general rule that you had to be 21 to vote. After much political debate, the Supreme Court case in which the justice opinions were divided, Congress finally lowered the national voting age to 18. In the 26th Amendment, the minimum age was set at 18 for both state and national elections.
Northern Ireland, 13 unarmed civilian rights demonstrators were shot dead by British armed paratroopers in an event that became known as Bloody Sunday. The protesters, all Northern Catholics, were marching in protest of British policy of internment of suspected Irish nationalists. British authorities had ordered the march banned and sent troops to confront the demonstrators when it went ahead. The soldiers fired indiscriminately into the crowd of protesters, killing 13 and wounding 17. The killings brought worldwide attention to the crisis in Northern Ireland and sparked protests all across Ireland. In Dublin, the capital of independent Ireland, outraged Irish citizens lit the British embassy aflame on February 2nd. The crisis in Northern Ireland escalated in 1969 when British troops were sent to the British possession of to suppress nationalist activity by the Irish Republican Army, or the IRA, and to quell religious violence between Protestants and Catholics. In April 1972, the British government released a report exonerating British troops from any illegal actions during the Londonderry protests. Irish indignation over Britain's Northern Ireland policies grew, and Britain increased its military presence in the north while removing any vestige of Northern self-rule. On July 21, 1972, the IRA exploded 20 bombs simultaneously in Belfast, killing British militant personnel and a number of civilians. British responded by instituting a new court system composed of trial without jury for terrorism suspects, and conviction rates topped over 90%. The IRA officially disarmed in September 2005, finally fulfilling the terms of historic 1998 Good Friday peace agreements. It was hoped that the disarmament would bring with it an end to the decades of politically motivated bloodshed in the region. Hello, and this is the news report on India joining the nuclear club. India has detonated a 12-kiloton nuclear explosive in the Rajasthan desert using plutonium from a research reactor donated from Canada in 1956. Since India has suffered disputes with China and refused to sign a nuclear non-proliferation treaty in 1968, they feel it necessary to make stronger impressions on China. Fearing a second war with China and a fourth war with Pakistan, India actively sought the development of a nuclear deterrent in the early 1970s. And finally, today, they tested it. British engineer Godfrey Hounsfield of EMI Laboratories has helped England invent a device that can look in deep inside our brains. Though it sounds like the work of science fiction, he has made it a reality. They work by multiple x-ray pictures that focus on each layer of the brain and moves to the next layer once one picture is taken. These X-rays are a form of radiation, but it is used in relatively small amounts, and the inventors have said that it is not that bad of a threat. It takes several days to receive this data from the computer, but it is a lot safer and quicker than a traditional surgery or biopsy. As of 1974, they have started installing CAT scans in select hospitals and medical research facilities.
I think we've all seen and been amused by Pong at one time or another. It was invented in 1972 by Nolan Bushnell at Atari. Once this game arrived in arcades, nothing would ever be the same. Avoid missing the ball for points, is what they said. Home Pong was released for the consumer in 1974, which was made possible with a drop in the price of microchips. This system, this game system of Pong, I believe, is the game we will mostly all remember.
Hello, we are here today, hours after the breakup of the famed band, the Beatles, to talk to the catalyst for their end, Paul McCartney. Hello, Paul. How are you?
Not so well, man. You know, my band is broke up because no one really cared anymore.
How do you know they didn't care, Paul?
Well, people were just not showing up, being lazy, you know, trying to go to other things in life.
Who do you think caused the most trouble within the group?
I'd probably say John. He just kept hanging out with his wife and he was ditching off band practice and weren't getting stuff done.
What do you think you're going to do now that your band's broken up?
I don't know, probably split up a little bit. I'm thinking about going into some pop music. You know, pretty nice.
Well, I believe that's all we need from you now. Thank you for talking to us so soon about this breakup. Back to you, Tiffany, on two details of the breakup. In the end, the love you take is equal to the love.
Rocky for the past 6 years, but now, in 1975, they have officially broken up. John Lennon, Paul McCartney, Ringo Starr, and George Harrison have decided to go their separate ways and begin personal projects. When they originally considered breaking up in 1969, McCartney was quoted saying, "There's only two choices. We're going to do it, or we're not going to do it, and I want a decision." His frustration came from an apparent lack of interest from his bandmates, and led him to say, "I don't see why any of you, if you're not interested, got yourselves into this. Why are you here? I'm here because I want to do a show, but I don't see an awful lot of support." Tension has apparently been rising since then, and over the last 6 years, this beloved band has split up to pursue other objects. Projects.
Sent inside forever.